Well, we still do not know why the former head of Michigan's health department abruptly left his post back in January. He bailed in the midst of a pandemic and swirling questions about the governor's nursing home policy. But tonight, we do know more about just how rare it is for that golden parachute to be handed out. Tonight, 7 investigator Ross Jones has new details about the payout that the governor is not eager to talk about.
Government transparency is important to me.
Since coming under fire for issuing two of her top lieutenants sizable severance payouts in exchange for their silence, Governor Whitmer has tried repeatedly to defend the practice. First, when the news came out.
Separation agreements, to your question, are used often in the public and private sector.
And again, just the next day.
It is not uncommon for a separation agreement to be struck, whether it is in the private sector or the public sector.
But just how common are payouts that come with a vow of silence? We asked the Michigan Department of Health and Human Services just how many severance agreements were given out since 2016 that included confidentiality clauses. Remember, that's the State Department that Robert Gordon led until abruptly resigning in January and receiving a $155,000 payout. The answer? Dating back the last 5 years, the only severance deal that came with a confidentiality clause was Robert Gordon's.
I'm very surprised, given that the governor says these are routine. They're used all the time.
State Senator Jim Runestad says this only raises more questions. He and other Republicans have long been critical of the COVID restrictions enforced by MDHHS, as well as the administration's nursing home policy.
And for them to collude together to have this hush money program set up so that he doesn't have to talk about any of the things that we're now seeing are huge in terms of mismanagement. I think it's a terrible example.
The governor has denied that the severance is hush money. And when we asked her office for comment today, a spokesperson said that when the governor called the separation agreements common, she wasn't talking about their confidentiality clauses, too. He also pointed to recent reporting showing that the Michigan legislature has used confidentiality agreements as well. Still, for a governor who preached transparency when she was a candidate, Runestad says she's not putting it into practice.
She should have stuck with what she was promising on the campaign trail, and that is to keep an open and transparent government.
And while Republicans say they want to ban payments that come with confidentiality clauses, the governor is actually moving in the opposite direction. On Friday, she issued an executive directive protecting them going forward. We're in Southfield tonight. I'm Ross Jones, 7 Action News.